Good morning, children. So it is symmetry, and yesterday we have seen the line of symmetry in some geometrical figures. Now today we will see how we will draw line of symmetry in alphabets. So for that we will use capital alphabets. Okay. And the question is written. Write the capital letters of English alphabet in your notebook. Try to draw their axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry means the same line of symmetry. Which ones have an axis of symmetry? Now see, all the alphabets have line of symmetry is not necessary. Okay, some have one line of symmetry, some have two, some have more than two, or some have no line of symmetry. Which ones have more than one axis of symmetry? So for that we have to draw the capital letters and we'll see. So let's, we will draw capital letters. So here, so for that we will draw A. So you have to properly draw. Okay, so I am using here the word draw. Okay, see, so B, H R G P L N N S P U V W X Y Z. So these are the capital alphabet. Okay, so and the axis of symmetry is shown by the dotted line. Okay, so let's draw C. So how many lines of symmetry or axis of symmetry you will draw C from here, from this vertex of A. So capital letter A has only one axis of symmetry. So See children, you have to draw in such a way that they become two equal parts. So from here, B. So if you fold it, it will exactly coincide. C. C. So by this line, if you fold, it will exactly overlap it. D. E. So from this axis, F. See children, if you draw a vertical and if you fold, it will not overlap. And if you draw a horizontal, so again it will not exactly coincide. So that's why it has no line of symmetry. G also, you can't draw the axis of symmetry. H. So from this, and yesterday we have seen better. H. I has an horizontal line of symmetry. J. C. In the capital letter J, you can't draw vertical or you can't draw horizontal. So it also have no line of symmetry. K, see, if you draw an axis like this and fold, so it will exactly overlap. L also, no. So you can write M like this. Now, you can draw a vertical line and also has no line of symmetry. O. Now tell me children, what is the shape of this O? It is circular, and yesterday we have seen a circle has infinite number of line of symmetry. See children, O is a circular, but the zero, number zero, the shape of number zero is oval. It is zero. Okay? So, it has infinite number of line of axis. P, no. Q, no. R, S, T. So if you try to draw a vertical, so it will divide it into two equal. U, yes, U has one line of symmetry, one vertical. Fold it, you will get these two parts are exactly coincide with each other. V, one line of symmetry. W, X, similar. So for X, you can draw a vertical and also you can draw a horizontal line of symmetry. Y has no line of symmetry and Z is also no line of symmetry. Okay. Got it, children? So, how many alphabets or which are the alphabets that have no line of symmetry? So, it is F, F, G, L, M, P, Q, R, S, and Y, Z. Okay, so how many alphabets that have two line of symmetry? Say children, here some confusion. If you draw the eye like this, so it will have two line of symmetry. Got it, Peter? So two line of symmetry are. And which are the alphabets that have one line of symmetry? It is A, B, C, D, E, H, and then T, U, V, W. An infinite line of symmetry, which letter has, it is O. So got it, children? So in this way, you will be able to draw the axis of symmetry. Got it, children? So now let's see beta, drawing symmetrical figures on graph paper. So children, have you seen the graph paper? See beta, it is the graph paper. So what you have seen here, boxes. Boxes means squares. So squares are drawn in the graph paper. Okay. And each square has definite area. Definite area means have their definite dimensions. Dimensions means length and breadth. Okay. So all squares has same dimensions, length and breadth. Generally we will say it is 1 square centimeter. So if you remember, in the last year we have learned the area of the square. Yes, area of the square is what? Length into breadth. So its length and breadth both are the same. So here we will try to draw the symmetrical figures. Okay. Okay, so children, with the use of this, you can draw symmetrical figure. So for that, each square has the same dimension. So suppose if I draw dotted line, this is line of axis, and one figure is given like this. Now you, through this line of symmetry, you have to complete the figure. So how will you complete, see beta? So here, line of symmetry, and it is 1 square. So you have to take this square, and for that, see, the line is diagonal. So also you have to draw draw a diagonal to it. Again one more diagonal. So see children, our figure is complete. Okay, now see the another. See beta, the graph lines are very light. Okay, so that you can see clearly the line of symmetry and the figure. So if I draw a line of symmetry here and you have to complete this figure. Okay, and you have to complete this figure exactly to the next. So it is one square is taken and it is the diagonal and then join it to axis. So you have to do the same thing. Now see, the diagonal is in the two squares, one, two. So you have to take two squares over here and draw a line towards the line of axis. Okay, now see beta here, how many squares are taken? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to take the four squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is the diagonal. Got it? So see, the given figure is exactly divided into two parts through this line of axis. Got it, children? So it is a vertical line of symmetry. See one more figure. Okay, so here we will draw a hole. It is the horizontal line of symmetry. And through this horizontal, you have to draw the figure. First is so have you seen this figure, beta? Okay, so you have to complete this. So horizontal line of symmetry is drawn. So you have to see, start from this. So you have to draw a diagonal like this. So it goes up. So you go down. Then go through this. Then it comes down, so for that you go up. Now go straight. How many squares? 1, 2. So it is 1, 2. So you have to go straight to two squares. Here it comes down, so here you go. So So got it, children? So through this line of symmetry, we will able to draw. We will able to divide the given figure into two equal halves. So got it, children? How to use the graph paper to draw the line of axis of symmetry or to the figure divided into two equal halves. So we will stop over here, beta. So bye bye, children.